Kính chào tất cả quý khán thính giả của đài ENT 57.10. Chương trình Investment Talk ngày hôm nay xin mang đến với quý vị những thông tin về những sự xây dựng mà không được cấp giấy phép, tiếng Anh gọi là illegal additions. Thì hôm nay chúng tôi có mời đến một chuyên gia về lĩnh vực này. Cô có rất là nhiều kinh nghiệm trong việc hợp thức hóa những cái cơ sở xây dựng mà không có giấy phép. Chúng tôi xin mời quý vị đến sự hiện diện có mặt của cô Diane Pan đến từ Illegal Addition Made Legal. Hi, can you introduce yourself to the audience?
Yes, please? I'd be happy to. My name is Diane Pan and I have a company called Plans R Us Illegal Additions Made Legal. I specialize in making illegal additions legal. That's all we do. We solve them in 5 counties. And we assist homeowners, spec builders, developers, anyone who has a question about their property in making sure that it's legal.
Thank you so much for being here today to share with the audience about your knowledge.
Thank you.
And first of all, I would like to ask you, what are illegal additions and how to recognize them?
Okay. Illegal additions, by definition, are any unapproved construction or structure added to a property. You buy a property, it comes with a certificate of occupancy. That document says what you have. If you have anything extra, it's illegal.
I see.
How to recognize them? If your certificate of occupancy says 4 bedrooms, 3 baths, and you have 4 bedrooms, 6 baths, 3 of those are illegal.
So you mean like it have to be based on paper, you know? It cannot be like recognized by eyes, right?
All information regarding mortgages and homes in the state of California must be in writing. Documents state that you buy a specific thing.
So does the homeowner must remove his illegal additions if the city find out?
That's a two-part answer. Mr. Inspector wants the paperwork off his desk. He'll say tear it down. You as the homeowner, if in fact you did construct it, or even if you did not construct it, it could be a sizable piece of your home. Before you take anything down, find out as much information about it so that you can make an informed decision about whether you should take it down or shouldn't take it down. But just to tear it down, no.
So if they shouldn't tear the illegal addition down, so how they can fix it?
My company specializes in doing just that. Whenever you add anything to your home, building and safety, or the judicial authority that governs your property, because we all live in cities, has specific rules about what you can do. Now, you can always add a bathroom. There's no rule on that. As long as it meets the required building codes. You can add an addition to your home, as long as it meets the required building codes. Once that building is on, it is by law considered to be substandard. Substandard means that it was not inspected.
I see. So from what you say, like homeowners who have illegal addition should hire some expert to help them make it legal, right?
Yes, if they want the value.
So will is expensive if the homeowners, you know, want to make it become legal?
It is more expensive to tear it down because you've already spent the money. Now, as I tell all homeowners, we draw a line on a piece of paper, we look at the amount of money that you've spent, and we look at the cost to what it will be to make it legal. If this is $50,000 and this is $5,000, then you spend the $5,000 because you get the value of the $50,000. And now that you have that value, your property value just went up.
I see.
And you're safer.
That's right. So basically, like, the homeowners have to sit down with the expert to calculate the the cost and the benefit, right?
That is correct. My company provides a thing called a site investigation report. It tells you the who, what, when, where, how long, and how much it will take for you to make your property legal. Once you have that report, now you can make an informed decision because you have all the facts.
Okay, so you have everything in black and white?
Black and white.
To make your decision.
Exactly. You need to know what you have, what you don't have, and how much it will cost to make it legal.
Okay, so how long does this process take to make everything become legal?
It's a two-part process. The first thing we do is the site investigation report. So you can find out the who, what, when, where, how mm-hmm. long, and how much. Then you sit down and you make your decision. In that, it will talk about you need a set of plans, you may need an engineer, you may need a variety of things. The time frame can be as little as 6 weeks. It could be, if you are required to have entitlements, i.e. a variance or a modification, it could be as long as a year. It just depends upon your condition.
Okay, so you mean like it have to based on like what kind of illegal addition exists. And from there,
yes,
you know, the expert can help you with all the issue.
That is correct.
And it long or short depends on those illegal addition.
Exactly. Right? It depends upon the conditions of. Our company typically handles it from the first phone call through the construction.
Mm.
That way, you as Mr. or Mrs. Homeowner, or Mr. and Mrs. Builder, because you're not an expert at this, you will learn to be an expert, because I am a firm believer that if you own a home, you should know how to go through the process.
I see. So how about like the mortgage process? Will the illegal addition will affect to the loan process?
Yes, it can. Years ago, before the mortgage meltdown, just about anything could get purchased in a mortgage. Since 2009 to 2015 now, the mortgage companies have the right not to approve your mortgage because there is a substandard condition on the property that they want to insure. Could this illegal addition fall into the house? Could it damage the house? They don't want to take that risk anymore.
Oh, so
we live in an earthquake area. Mm. If this building that is attached to your legal building, if it's not done correctly, and we have an earthquake, it could damage your existing building. There are all sorts of little rules and laws which are in place to keep us safe.
Thank you so much. And can you give some example of illegal addition?
Oh, yes.
So the audience can understand more than just the unpermitted rooms.
Typically, people will add a master bedroom and a master bath. That's the typical one. They think that, okay, it's my property, I can do what I want. And they can't, because we live next to neighbors. Garage conversions. People think that they can have someone move into the garage, but cars live in garages. People don't.
Mm-hmm.
And there are rules for all of these things. And these are the rules that keep us safe. So, if you want to build it without a permit, you are putting yourself potentially in harm's way with liability, because if it's not inspected, and a piece of drywall falls from a ceiling. Most of our homes have 8-foot ceilings. A piece of drywall falling and hitting me will hurt me. It could kill a child.
Wow, and that's dangerous.
And it's very dangerous. But you don't, as a homeowner, you don't know. When Mr. Inspector comes out to inspect the number of nails in a ceiling, he will pass it and say that it is sufficient, or he will say, no, put more. That is to protect you, the homeowner.
From all the liability.
From the liability, correct.
That's the very like serious issue.
It's very serious, very serious.
Because when it happened like that, the lawyer...
Lawyers will eat you alive.
Wow.
They will own you. Especially if you did the illegal addition. Especially if you did it. And why put the largest investment that you have in a situation that it could hurt someone?
Wow, very interesting,
Thank
Diane.
You.
Từ nãy đến giờ là những thông tin rất là chung về những sự xây dựng không có hợp lệ, tiếng Anh gọi là illegal additions.